Alright, welcome you to Brain School Galaxy, where you learn inside these stuffs on information technology and acquire new skills that exponentially elevate your worth in the marketplace and in business. I'm Ibrahim Tabat, but it's okay you call me T-Max because I tremendously make it pop maximum. I'm going to be your host and your coach for this training series today. So without any further ado, let's cut this cheese and let's head over where the real stuff happens. Alright, see you there.
So I told you I was going to give you a video on five reasons why you should learn web design. So here we are. So let's ride on. So basically, I know without any doubt you are familiar with websites and the internet, and you have indisputably interfaced with them, whether it be social media websites, e-commerce websites you shop on, or random websites you visit for information and stuff. You have interfaced with websites. So let's look at some of the five reasons why you should design, why you should learn web design. One of the first reasons why I think you should learn web design is it would elevate your worth and any potential in the corporate world. Like if you're an entrepreneur, if you're currently an employee, or probably you're seeking out to, you know, delve into the corporate world, it is a powerful tool, and it is a skill set. If you have under your belt, it will exponentially elevate your worth and any potential in the corporate world, because everything that happens in the business and corporate world revolves around ability to sell, ability to acquire customers, generate leads, you know, and all that. So, and we are in a digital dispensation now. If you learn this skill, like you learn how to design websites, it means you could create platforms where companies are able to execute, you know, their marketing strategies on. Digital marketing strategies they revolve around the internet, they revolve around websites. So, I mean, this is a very powerful skill to acquire. And secondly, you would be able to bet your creative ideas to life. Yes, a lot of us have a lot of ideas. You know, the most of the websites you see online now are products of, you know, people's ideas and inventions. You know, the Facebook, all of us are always hovering on it. It was an idea in Mark Zuckerberg's mind a couple of years back, you know, but it's a reality now. So you possibly have your own idea. You have, you know, whatever ideas you have, you could bet them. And the good thing about websites is you are not limited, you're not limited in scope and dimensions of the audience you reach. You could stay in your room and design a website that offers, you know, some value or dispenses some kind of value, and you reach out to people around the world. The third reason why you should learn web design is you would avoid being scammed by web designers out there. You're possibly wondering, I mean, web designer, why am I saying this? Yes. You know, if you're not familiar with web technologies, you're not familiar with the terminologies in web design, a web designer will blow off your mind when you meet him for a web design project. For instance, yeah, he might be telling you stuff like, okay, we're going to get you hosting, we're going to get you domain name, we're going to, you know, install SSL certificates, we're going to do search engine optimization. But if you're not familiar with these terms, you'll be blown off and be like, he could give you an outrageous price, and you're like, really? You know, but the truth is, you would have a big bargaining power if you understand these terminologies, or you even know how to set up this platform. So if it happens that you're building up businesses and you do not have time anymore to build the website yourself, if you call a web designer to do a job for you, you're telling specifically what you want him to execute for you. Please get me this domain name, please get me this hosting, I want you to install this SSL certificate. The web designer knows that you know what you're doing, you know what you're telling him to do, so you cannot play around. And also, if somebody's managing your website, you already know how to manage websites, so you're telling him, please do this for me, I want to get the analytics for the campaigns you're executing. So he's not just going to be out there doing crazy stuff and you don't even know what he's doing. Like recently I met a client, she's a real estate consultant, and she has spent so much money, you know, paying to a web designer, and she doesn't even know what the guy's doing. You know, that's crazy. Imagine the money she has spent and she has no clue what the guy is doing. You know, so I told her that's a big problem, because you are not even asking him to give you analytics. You should be able to see the traffic is generating, you should be able to see the leads is generating for a business, the campaigns, the social media adverts is running, the Google adverts is running, you should be able to see the result. Are you paying money and he's actually not even doing anything and he's telling you he's doing something? So you need to understand these things, you need to understand this technology. That's one of the reasons why you should never resign. So fourthly, the fourth reason why I think you should learn web design is you would be able to build new income streams and businesses online. See, you're not limited to the businesses you can build. If you have an idea to set up an e-commerce website where you sell some products and you sell some services, it doesn't limit you. Tomorrow you might have another idea to go into the health and fitness, you know, want to be teaching people how to lose weight. You have some lose weight products and stuff. You could set up numerous platforms, and those are, you know, you could have multiple streams of income, and it is a very powerful tool, because you can stay in the comfort of your home and build businesses online that generate you some decent income. I really think you should put that into consideration. All right, so last reason why you should learn web design is, you will minimize cost in building and managing your startup marketing channels. See, if you're starting up a new business as an entrepreneur, a lot goes into setting up your marketing platforms. Like, for instance, now you will get a web designer, he designed the website, he will possibly do search engine optimization for you, do social media integration, and also create your landing pages, your email campaigns, you know, funnels and all that. It's going to cost you a lot. And beyond that, to manage your platforms is a different thing entirely. You know, for him to design the website, that project is completed. But for the website to keep, you know, you have to keep teaching out content. You need to be creating blogs, you need to be putting out content, you know, whether adding new products to your product list, whatever it is, you have to keep managing the website, and it's going to cost you a lot. You, as a new startup, you might not have a lot of money to throw around, you know, so it's not a bad idea. You understand how to set up, and it's very good these days because there are new technology. A decade back, it's for you to design a website, you needed to be a programmer, you needed to understand, you know, Java, you needed to understand HTML, CSS, and the rest of all those, and programming, you know, platforms. Now we have content management systems like WordPress, Drupal, Joomla. So you can, I know Wix, also a lot of you know Wix, I don't know if you know, but you could create a website and you can be a professional web designer in a month. I mean, and the thing is, when I started out in web design, I didn't have a coach, I didn't have someone guiding me, so I had to depend on online resources, downloading videos online, getting softwares, and consistently I kept on trying stuff, you know, I was failing in these areas and all that, but you know, finally I know diverse areas of web design now, so it's a good thing. It will actually minimize your cost in setting up your marketing funnels. Like, you know how to create your landing pages that acquire leads and customers online, you know how to do search engine optimization, you will know how to integrate social media, you know, into your website, so that when you share your content, they go to all your social media platforms, and that will also attract traffic to your website. You also know how to manage the audience on your platform, you know, I mean, it's a powerful tool for you. So the possibilities are limitless, so I think it's something you should explore. So also some technologies you'll be interfacing and utilizing in this whole process is basically you'll be learning how to buy domains, how to set up your hosting, you know, and one of the technologies you're going to use in creating your website is WordPress. WordPress is one of the best content management systems out there on the web. So some other technologies you're going to be interfacing it with is SEO. You have to be doing search engine optimization, but the fact that you design a beautiful professional website doesn't mean it's going to be found by your target audience. You need to do SEO and also use other tools like Google Keyword Planner to do keyword research. Know what people are searching on the web on their mobile phone, so use that to optimize pages on your website. Google Analytics, of course, you need to know the results, you know, that is being produced from the campaigns or the marketing you're running. And also Microsoft Office. Somebody's wondering what Microsoft Office has to do with web design. The slides you're seeing was created in PowerPoint. So you would, and one powerful area in your content management is you need to create content. You need to always consistently create content, because it's your content that lead back to your website. The blog posts you create, the content you share on the web leads back to your website. That's how the traffic comes. That's how you attract. It's like the bait that attracts people to your platform. So you need to know how to use these technologies. Google AdWords. Yes, you're starting out. You have not built, you know, a massive audience online. So you need to use ads. You know, that's where Google AdWords come. You know how to create ads. You know, that attract traffic, the right target audience to your business. MailChimp, you know, you need to know email marketing, Adobe. Of course, this video was edited in Premiere Pro. That cinematographic effect you saw was created in After Effects. So other resources you will need to use is Alexa. You check your ranking, compare them with your competitors. You know, I know what your competitors are doing, what are the backlinks they are getting, you know, and all that. It helps you in the whole process. Paystack, if you want to integrate payment where people use credit cards to pay for stuff on your platform, on your website, you know, you use stack as one of your payment processor, you know. So Huge Suite for dishing out your content and scheduling your posts on social media, you know. Also you learn how to use Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, Instagram and other social media platforms to attract traffic to your website. So it's really awesome hanging out with you. So if you're interested in having a personal coach to take you through this whole process of web design, well, you could reach out to us at Briscoe Galaxy. We have a team of tech geeks that are passionate about empowering people with the requisite knowledge and tech skill to maximize their potential. So this is what we do every day. So nice hanging out with you. So if you want to contact us, you can reach out to us here at this contact details here. Most of our trainings happens at Bedney Apartment, Victoria Land, Lagos, and you can email us at info@briscoe.org. It's really a honor hanging out with you, and have a great time. See you around.